So after blowing that hydraulic line, we got the loader up on life support here. We've come with the necessary tools to fix it. One being the angle grinder. This is the fitting that blew. So the angle grinder and grind that flat. Put some tape up all around that hose, and then go nuts with the angle grinder. So then we can put that fitting back on, and then we should have enough reach to be able to get it hooked back up. But yeah, we left it, and look, I'm surprised that it's still up in the air. That's a good sign that these seals are really good. And of course, we blocked the inside. We put a nice little rag in there, so no filings or anything will get in when we're cutting.
Yeah, so we got it started threading, and now we just gotta thread the top part in to lock it down.
That bottom one has to be turned a little bit more.
Yeah.
But at least we got the thread started.
Yeah. It's a double threading system.
And this kind of locks on.
Then we put it on that pipe.
This is the easy part. The hard part's getting it to line up.
To the connector?
Yeah. I'm surprised it went. Yeah, it's good. Everything kind of lined up.
So yeah, we'll get that fixed and back on there and get this big beast up and running. Now we got this tire all aired up. Gotta love an air compressor.
Pants and I had to tag team it because my arm was getting sore. This has got two spots to put hydraulic fluid. It's got this one here, and then it's got one up there, right on the other side of that door. This stuff is not cheap.
Alright, put it all the way up, all the way down, the bucket all the way forward, back. Doesn't seem to be any leaks. Everything looks good and dry. So we successfully shortened that hose there, and it made it work, so we lucked out.
The beautiful thing about this asphalt is you just leave it, come back, and it just kind of splits on its own. You just leave it. All we did was push it out of the way when the hydraulic line blew, and then come back to it and look at it. It just splits on its own. So now that it's broken up into smaller chunks, now it's just a matter of lifting it up and then letting it fall, and then hopefully we come back and it's broken up some more even yet. Of course, if it was hot, this would be a lot easier to do. Pants is getting off some tires. Okay, so hopefully that's got some stress fractures developing in it, and we'll come back and it'll be broken up even more. A couple big blows like that, and it's really stressful to the asphalt, so we'll just keep on plugging away at it.